guys, Laura here. I'm here today to do the If I Stay movie review by Gail Foreman, one of my subscribers or commenters asked me to review this, so I'm doing this for them. I really like the movie. I gave it 5 stars for an adaptation, which is sometimes really hard to do, but I thought that the parts in the book that I didn't like were really were made better in the movie. I think one of my issues with the book is that it was so short. And I thought that, like, the minute you got into the world, it kind of made you come out of it. But I really liked how they did it, and I liked how the timeline was kind of altered a little bit in the movie. I really liked the casting. I love Chloe Grace Moretz, and I know some people had a little bit of issues with her, but I really liked her in the role. And I know she recently got cast in the Fifth Wave movie, so I'll be really excited to see what she does with that series as well. But I really liked her. I thought she was able to capture Mia very, very well. And I liked the back and forth of it. I liked, in the movie, I thought it was a little bit confusing because you didn't know when scenes were happening. But in the movie, they basically went in chronological order, which I thought was really helpful to me as an audience member, because that was the one thing in the book I was like, when is this happening? When is this referenced? So they kind of changed in the movie and had everyone go in chronological order, which for me was really helpful. I really liked the presence of music from both Mia and Adam. It was two totally different sides of music, but, you know, one's classical and one's rock. But I thought that was, again, really interesting. And one of my favorite scenes was when she was in the kitchen with her mom and she was talking after she broke up, I guess you could say, with Adam. I thought that was, like, a very, very honest scene. And it was really well acted. I love the little brother. It was really sad. But, you know, I thought it was a very good book. If you like If I Stay, I recommend you go read it. And if you haven't read the book, go see it and then read the book. It's a really short book. It's like 250 pages, at least in America it is. I don't know if it's altered in different countries. But yeah, I really liked it. I love the casting. I am really excited to read Where She Went. And I really hope that they make a sequel to it because I think it lends itself very well and I'd love to see what happened. Because the ending, again, like the book was so open-ended that you kind of need a sequel. But yeah, I really liked it. I love it had almost like an indie feel to it. And I love movies like that. I recently saw A Fault in Our Stars and it was a big blockbuster, obviously, but it had a very like homegrown feel, and that's kind of a really interesting way to do that movie, and I think it's kind of the only way to do it. And I think that this movie also showed that with writers involved, it really has an effect on it and made it very, very book-like, I think. And I think John Green and Gail Foreman are very reliable in that. And I know in the future we have looking forward to Rainbow Rowell, who's adapting, I think it's Eleanor and Park she's adapting, so I'm excited to see again where that goes. But yeah, that is my thoughts. I'm going to see Maze Runner on Thursday, and I did read the book, so I'm going to do another movie review, so keep a nose out for that. But yeah, let me know what you guys thought of the movie below. What were your comments? What did you guys think? Did you guys like the casting? Did you like the changes? I was a fan of them, but, you know, some people are not. So I would love to hear your guys' thoughts. So yeah, keep the dialogue open below. Check out my Goodreads, Twitter, any of the links I put below, my book-like blogs. And yeah, have a very nice day, everyone.